If Calvinists are honest and committed to their model, they will not sugarcoat their gospel, but to tell it as it is without compromise and not misleading their listeners. They should not worry, as they are not appealing to anyone to want to believe them. If any is predestined to believe, they will anyway. So, if they were really honest, they must speak according to what they believe.
I agree. They must decide to tell it straight. Let me tell it like it is. The Reformed Gospel of Jesus Christ. Friends, I want you all to know that God is sovereign over all things. He made all of you to fit His purpose. He decides what is best for His glory. Long ago, in eternity past, before man was created, God already decided which one of you will be saved. You are chosen. The rest, I'm afraid to say, will be rightly and justly condemned. Don't object. God is sovereign. Who are we to question God? How can the clay question the potter why you will or will not make it? God will have mercy to whom He has mercy.
The good news is this: God loves you all. Don't be surprised. God gave everyone here life and fresh air and sunshine. He loves you all with His benevolent love. But maybe some of you here He gave more, that God loves you more specifically and chosen you for eternal life. You are the elect. God loves the elect with a particular love, in a different sense, a very special sense.
If you are the elect tonight, you will believe in Jesus Christ. God will turn your heart of stone into heart of flesh. That's the new life. Then God will give you a great gift. The gift of faith to believe in Jesus. As Lord, not merely Savior. You will believe Jesus is Lord, else it is not true faith. This faith will be your first evidence that you are the elect, by the faith God will give you. Know this, that you cannot save yourself. You cannot boast. It is all God, none by you.
This is the best good news you can ever hear, the gospel of Jesus Christ. He loves specifically those of you who will believe in Him. For those of you who believes in Jesus tonight by the faith God gives you, your life will be transformed and some of you may go on doing great things for Him. However, this does not guarantee that you are chosen by Him to spend eternity in His presence.
You may manifest all the traits of belonging to Him, but really, none of us can know 100% for sure until after we die. This is the sovereignty of God at work, and there's nothing we will be able to do about it. Those of you who are truly the elect, you will be preserved to the very end with the faith that God gives you. In fact, you will never need to worry about losing your salvation, no matter if your life may still be sinful. That's okay, the righteousness of Christ is all God sees, not your sins.
After all, you have been predestined by God before the world began, and God, who is sovereign, will see to it that you will be preserved. God is the one who does it all from beginning to end. God is angry with all men, but God loves you, elect people of God, whoever you are, if you're here tonight. The fact that God has actually chosen to save some of you is amazing grace, because all of us only deserve hell. Isn't this truly good news? So for those whom God has elected, if you're here tonight, I want you to know that God loves you immensely. If you have the desire to believe in Jesus as Lord, we want to speak with you and bless you.
Are there any elect here tonight? All glory to God. It's the work of Christ on the cross, His mighty work. This message lifts up Christ, the center of our gospel, our preaching of the cross. Praise and glory solely to God. Amen.